The name of this video is Parallel Plate Capacitor with Dielectric Material Part 2. The aim of this video is to find the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor partially filled with an IRH material that we examined in the previous video using the simplest tools we have in our toolbox. That is, without resorting, for example, to the more complicated Laplace equation method with boundary conditions, which, however, we are going to consider in a few videos from now. So I remind you that we have four interfaces. A, B, C, and D, representing respectively. Capital A is where we have the positive charge, free charge, plus sigma F. Capital D is where we have minus sigma F, therefore making this a parallel plate capacitor, balance and opposite sign for the charge. Here we have conducting material in MEE, whereas here we have an ILH dielectric material. You can refer to the sketch in the previous video for more details about the various lengths which are involved in this problem. And so, what is the simplest way to calculate the capacitance of this object? Well, first of all, we need to remind ourselves what is the definition of capacitance, which we encountered in an introducing Phys 242. So the capacitance is always given by, no matter what, regardless whether I have a dielectric material or not, is given by the positive free charge QF. So it's the positive free charge. And why is that? Because the capacitor is something we use in the lab, right? So it's in a circuit element, a circuit which we use to perform experiments. What is the handle in our hands? It's QF, it's not QP. QP is a consequence that there is polarization. And so the only handle we have in our hands is QF. So QF is what we use in order to tune up a capacitor. Okay, so that's our handle. That's why in the capacitance we have QF plus the positive QF divided by the overall potential difference delta V between the two plates of the capacitor. In this case, the plates are A and B. So delta V is between A and B. In fact, delta V must be always computed as V on the positively charged plate, which is A, minus V, the potential at D, which is the negatively charged plate. And again, in the numerator, we have QF plus definition of capacitance from 242. In order to compute this, we need QF plus and the potential difference. The easy thing to compute is the potential difference. In fact, delta V can be computed by means of the superposition principle for the potential, for the electric potential. And so in this case, we can compute it as the sum of three potential differences. The one between A and B, the one between B and C, and the one between C and D. So I'm going to have V at A minus V at B plus V at B minus V at C plus V at C minus V at D. If now you sum it up, minus B plus B minus B plus C, they cancel out and we end up having V A minus V D, which is what we seek to find here for the denominator of C, the capacitance of this object. So how do we find this? What is the simplest way to find this? Obviously, we know that the electric field within the plates of this capacitor is uniform. So we have a uniform electric field E naught in the vacuum, and we have a uniform overall field. Let me do it properly. Let me sketch it much smaller because it is smaller. let me stress the fact that it's a smaller field. So this arrow here is longer than this arrow, where we have ED, the total field in the electric material, which is the linear superposition of the E naught plus the polarization field, which is a screening field. So this ED vector has to be smaller compared to E naught vector. Okay, and of course, back in vacuum, we have again our E naught vectors. And of course, these two vectors are exactly the same. So this vector and this vector are exactly the same length. Good. So now that this that we know qualitatively what's happening inside the electric material, how do we compute the potential difference? Obviously by means of the definition of work, because it's the work, of course, to move a particle within these walls. And so the unit particle. And so in this case, delta V can be rewritten with respect to the Cartesian coordinate system we have chosen in the previous video. I remind you that in that video, we had chosen the origin to be here, and this was our x-axis. And I remind you that this length here was L naught, this length here was LD, and this length here was L naught again, and not LD L naught. Okay, so under these conditions, delta V is given by, in this Cartesian coordinate system, the vector E naught, which is the magnitude E naught, times ux dotted with ux L naught, because it's a uniform field, so it's very simple to compute it. Similarly, for the region BC, we have plus ED, because there is where we have the dielectric material, ux dotted with ux LD. And finally, for the last region, which is vacuum again, we have exactly the same as in the previous, in the first region, so E naught at times ux, and dotted with ux, again, at times L naught, which is the length of the vacuum, the second vacuum region. And so the dot products give one, and so delta V, finally, can be written as, if I sum up here, I can sum up E naught and E naught. In addition to that, we can also remind ourselves what is the relationship between E naught and ED. And so we know that ED so ED must be larger or smaller than E naught. So stop for a minute, think about it, and come back. All right, so if you came back, you know that ED has to be screened, is partially screened, so it has to be smaller than E naught, as we know from here. And so by how much? By epsilon RD, which means that ED is epsilon RD times smaller compared to E naught. So I need to divide by a certain number and I find ED, okay, which is the relative permittivity of the ILH material in this case. So if we do that and we represent everything as a function of ED, for example, you can do the same for E naught. Well, in that case, E naught is epsilon RD ED, and so we can factor out an ED. We can factor out ED here. And in parentheses, we're going to have 2 times L naught from this and this contribution. So 2 times L naught, but E naught is epsilon RD ED, so times epsilon RD plus this contribution, which is just plus LD. So very simply, this is the potential difference between the positive and negative plates of this capacitor. So we have the denominator which we need for computing the capacitance. So the next hurdle is to compute QF. So how do we proceed in order to compute QF? Well, this can be done as follows. We need to use Coulomb's theorem. In fact, we know that the interface A, we know that E naught is equal to sigma F divided by epsilon naught, Coulomb's theorem. In addition, we know that E naught is epsilon RD ED, therefore, sigma F, which is epsilon naught E naught, is epsilon naught epsilon rd ed. Or if you want, is epsilon d ed. Which is nice because now we have sigma f as a function of ed, which is also something we have done here. Okay, so sigma f as a function of ed. We need to divide them somehow because sigma f contributes to qf, and so this already hints that we are on the long path, the proper path, the right path, because ed and ed will cancel out eventually. Okay, so how do we compute finally qf3 plus on, let's say, a, which is the only positive one in this case? Well, we need to do the area times sigma f. Sigma f times the area a, and so it's given by epsilon d times ed times the area a. Now, if we combine this result with this result in this definition, then obviously we obtain that the capacitance C is given by the ratio QF divided by delta B. So ED and ED cancel out, and so we are left with epsilon in the numerator. We have epsilon D from QF, ED is gone, divided by 2 times L naught epsilon RD plus LD, and the whole quantity has to be multiplied times the area A. So this is the capacitance in this specific case. Now, in 242, we already found the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor without IRH dielectric material, with vacuum. So we want to verify as a sanity check that actually, if we consider vacuum, we found the proper result. Do we? Well, the first sanity check is, let's consider vacuum. So in vacuum, it means that the ILH is vacuum, and so epsilon RD, we set it to 1, and as a consequence, the total length L, which in this case is equal to 2 times L naught because LD is equal to 0, L is 2 times L naught because LD is equal to 0. I set all the dielectric material to be 0, so we have vacuum, okay? So under these conditions, if we plug it in here, we find that. So here we have C naught, the capacitance for the vacuum case. We know what the result is. It should be epsilon naught divided by times the area divided by the length. So that's what we expect to find. So let's see if we find that. Well, here we have epsilon naught times epsilon RD. Epsilon RD is actually 1, so it's epsilon naught. And so this LD is equal to 0, so 2L naught is equal to L, and so we end up having exactly epsilon naught times the area divided by L. So again, epsilon RD is equal to 1, LD is equal to 0, so in the denominator we have 2 times L naught, which we just call L. This epsilon D is epsilon naught times epsilon RD, so it's epsilon naught times A over L, which is exactly the capacitance we know is correct for a capacitor which is filled with vacuum, okay? So we also know from a previous video that if we want to increase the capacitance of a capacitor, we introduce an ILH material. We have seen this generally a couple of videos ago. Is this correct in this specific case? Well, let's verify it. So how do we verify that? Well, we verify by assuming that there is the entire capacitor is filled by means of a dielectric material, for example, okay? So of course, it's true also in this case of partially filled, and I'll let you verify it, but as an extreme case, let us assume that there is no vacuum. And so if there is no vacuum, this means that the naught is equal to 0, okay? Which implies accordingly that in this case, L is equal to LD. Okay, so in this case, since we are in this condition that, LD, L naught is equal to 0, we end up having for the capacitance CD, when it's fully filled, is going to be given by, in the denominator, L naught is equal to 0, so LD is the only thing which remains. So we have epsilon D, which can be rewritten as epsilon RD, times epsilon naught, left from epsilon D, times A over L, because L, we call it LD, we call it L. in this case. But this is nothing but epsilon RD times C naught, because this is nothing but C naught, the capacitance in vacuum. So clearly CD, which is epsilon RD, and epsilon RD is a quantity which is larger than or equal than 1, since we are not in vacuum, is definitely larger than 1, it is larger than C naught, which is what exactly we expected. So this is exactly what we expected when we entirely fill this capacitor with the annihilation. Of course, this is also true in this middle case, where it's partially filled. This capacitor is also larger than C naught. This is the biggest you can get, is when you entirely fill it, which is also the easiest, because it's very hard experimentally to leave vacuum gaps on the left and on the right hand side here. Okay, so to recap this video, in this part two, we wanted to find the capacitance from the definition we know from 242, which is the free charge, which is our handle, divided by the potential difference, which is the overall potential difference between the positive and negative plates. How do we find this potential difference? Superposition principle, that is the sum of the potential differences for each region, back to back. We use the definition of work, the concept of work, to find it. And we express ED as a function of E naught, or E naught is a function of ED. You can do vice versa. In order to find the charge QF plus, of course, we need to use Coulomb's theorem. And again, this condition which we found in the previous video, by dividing, ED beautifully cancels out, and we end up with this definition of capacitance, which is very general, okay? And then as limiting cases, as sanity checks, we examined the full vacuum case, which of course gives us C naught, as we know from 242, and the case where the, this dielectric material extends all the way to A and D, so it's entirely filled with dielectric material, the capacitor, in which case, clearly the capacitance is larger than C naught, which in fact is the reason why people, one of the reasons why people tend to add a dielectric material is to increase the capacitance, as again, we have seen more generally in a previous video. That's it.